Hello, I'm David Lee, the Director of Prevention Services at the California Coalition Against Sexual Assault and our national project, Prevent Connect. Preventing intimate partner violence requires shifting our norms that contribute to intimate partner violence that happens in our society. Some of the important ones we have to realize is the socialization of men that makes violence acceptable behavior, and we have to be able to look at how we can shift that to be able to move things forward to create an environment where we won't see intimate partner violence taking place. Another norm that we have to shift is about that domestic violence or intimate partner violence is something that's silent and something that's not going to be discussed, and that we need to be able to have that become an open discussion of a topic that people can be able to explore. And finally, another norm that we have to look at is how do we create norms of what healthy relationships are and how we can relate with each other in healthy ways, and that we need to make that become the norm and the standard about how people act with each other. It is the time to act to be able to prevent intimate partner violence in our own communities, whether it's within our schools, within our cities, within our own communities. We need to be able to take action now. We must raise the issue. We must think about ways to promote healthy relationships. We need to ways about promoting healthy masculinity. We need to be able to promote ways to be able to say that we want to be able to see a community that exists without domestic violence or intimate partner violence. There are many things that people can do. School boards can look at adapting policies to be able to create healthy relationships and advance that throughout their system. Communities can be able to go over and support the leadership of young people in discussing these issues to be able to move forward. We can find ways to promote the safety of young, of all people, particularly young people, and that they should be safest when they're in their relationships. This is what it takes to be able to prevent intimate partner violence. Preventing intimate partner violence is about changing the systems that contribute to this. Part of this we need to do is promote true gender equity. We need to be able to find ways that create economic justice and opportunities for women to be able to speak, be able to earn the same as men, to be able to empower women and girls to be able to take action, to be able to have men be able to take action where they can speak out and be supportive of true gender equity. These are some of the ways that we can be able to make a difference. We also know that we have to interrupt the pathways that people who grow up in families with domestic violence can be able to learn new ways where they can have healthy relationships and not reproduce that violence. These are some of the things that we can do to be able to prevent intimate partner violence in our communities. At the California Coalition Against Sexual Assault and through our national project at Prevent Connect, we see there's many opportunities to be able to prevent both sexual violence and intimate partner violence, since many of them are caused by the same situations. We know that we need to be able to do work with faith communities. We know through the work we're doing in our other national project, Reliance, that sport is an incredible opportunity to be able to create change. And we can use tools that have been identified through public health and many of the great resources that the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention have put out to be able to be clear that we can be able to shift those norms and be able to make change. We see so much opportunity, so much progress being made, and what we want to do is build on the efforts that have been taking place in communities to be able to create that change so we can be able to prevent intimate partner violence and sexual violence in all of our communities.